Hello, and of course, welcome to the channel. I will be putting emphasis on markets that have been requested by people. First on the list is Nkosinathi. Nkosinathi requested me to explain what is a margin, what is a winning margin. Well, a winning margin is easy. Let's just look for a very popular league. Yeah, it's a pity that there's few popular leagues now, especially now that the big leagues are closed. Okay, I think Egyptian League is very popular. Let's quickly make an example with these two matches that are playing now at 6 o'clock. There's a team there called El Gona versus Ceramica Cleopatra. So these two teams are playing. Let me open these two teams here on my app, SofaScore app. There's Cleopatra versus El Gona. You can see the standings. First things first, you can see Cleopatra there being the better team in terms of standing. Of course, you can see they are on 40 points, the other is 31 points. So it means Cleopatra is winning more. Let's see the head-to-head stats. You can see also the head-to-head stats. There's not too many matches between those two teams. But Cleopatra, Ceramica Cleopatra, you can see they have won two matches, draw two, and then they were beaten one time by this El Gona. So meaning Cleopatra are coming out on top. Even the odds, if you can check the odds, you can see the odds are suggesting that Cleopatra must win this match. That's just according to the odds. That does not mean they will win. But nevertheless, let's just check the previous results and see how did they play. Okay, I can see that that was a draw of 1-1. Cleopatra beating them by a 3-2. Now, check that 3-2 score. You see here, this, if you have bet for Cleopatra, a winning margin of by one goal, you would have won here. Let me just show you now. It's quick, nice. Let's look for Cleopatra. So let's explain what is winning margin. Let's look for winning margin. Where is that market now? Okay, there it is, winning margin. So this is how winning margin works. You choose the team to win. First of all, you must know which team are you going to bet for. In this case, we are saying we're going to back Cleopatra to win this match. So now, if you're saying Cleopatra will win the match by only a goal, then you choose this one. You can see the Cleopatra by a goal. What does this mean? It means when, if they win by a goal, their scoreline can be 1-0, 1-0, or 2-1, or 3-2. Meaning the difference in scoreline will only be one goal. I hope you understand. For instance, if the score is 1-0, then that means the difference there is only one goal. Meaning if the other team can score, it can be a draw. Even if it's 2-1, that's still a difference of one goal. If the other team can score, it can be a draw, 2-2. You understand? And then even if Cleopatra wins this match by 3-2, if the other team can happen to score before the match ends, it can be a draw. And then it's 3-3 because the difference is only one goal. That's what it means when they say by one goal, winning margin by one goal. Meaning, for example here, this is a good example. You see here, Cleopatra, if you said by one goal, then this was going to be through because it's only a difference of one goal between the scoreline. Your team that you've backed, Cleopatra, have won the match by only a goal, difference of one goal. If you want to, if you want to get the difference right, just say 3 minus 2, then you will get 1. You understand? Even here, you can see, but it's a pity El Gona won this match by a goal, you know, by a difference of a goal, 3-2. Meaning that if you have chosen this market by one goal, but that now, but for El Gona this time around, as you can see here, because El Gona won. Yeah. But here, you can see Cleopatra has won the match by 2-1, meaning there's a difference of one goal again. If you want to see if the difference is really one goal, say 2 minus 1. Just say the scoreline of the winning team minus the scoreline of the losing team. Then if you get 1, then that means that's your answer for by one goal. If you don't get 1, then you've chosen the wrong market. So if you happen to choose this one now, Cleopatra by 2 goals, then that means when you minus the scoreline of Cleopatra to the scoreline of El Gona, you must get 2. Your answer must be 2. That's how simple I can explain this thing. So, and the advantages of this is that it has, you know, this market has nice money by the look of things. And I won't hesitate. I will put this Cleopatra by one goal. I think they will win by one goal because I can see all their previous matches. They have won by a margin of one here, and even here a margin of one. So I trust them to win by a margin of one again. So let's check other match again, because there's another match. There's Zamalek. I'm sure you're all familiar of Zamalek. It's another big team from Egypt in Africa. So let's look for, where is this? Doesn't look like they, oh, they have it, winning margins. So now, if we say, let's first check Zamalek, the previous results of Zamalek against that Ishmael FC standings. Let's check the standings. You can see Zamalek being on top. Okay. Ah, it's better. They are more or less the same. No. They are not more the same, because Zamalek have played few matches. So Zamalek should have been on top here. So Zamalek is very, very good here. It's superior against this team. So I say they will beat them. And you can see here the head-to-head. Zamalek won 13 matches. Ishmael won only 4. And they draw 3. You can see already even the odds. Hollywood is backing this team to win. But let's just check the previous matches. You can see, oh, damn. The last match they played, Zamalek lost the match by 2-1. Damn. But anyway, a match before that, Zamalek won. Yeah. So here's a good example now. Zamalek here won by 3-1. How do we know which market this thing falls into in terms of the winning margin? What you do is you say the scoreline of the winning team, which is Zamalek, minus the scoreline of the losing team, which is Ishmael. So you just say 3 minus 1. What do you get? You get 2. Meaning, this time around, for Zamalek here won by 2 goals. This is the market now. This was the right market. If you have chosen this one, 1, then you lost. That means it would have been a loss for you, because it's 3-1. The difference there, it's 2 goals. This team will have to score 2 goals for this match to be a draw. If the losing team have to score 2, then that means for it to be a draw, then that means this is the good one. This is the margin that you should have played for the winning team, Zamalek in this case. But now, let's check another match whereby Zamalek, you see here, Zamalek won this match again on a cup, and the scoreline was 1-0. So if you say 1 minus 0, what do you get? You still get 1. Meaning here, the margin here, the winning margin here is by 1 goal. So this is it. You should have chosen this one, Zamalek by 1 goal. You should have chosen Zamalek by 1 goal. And then let's check another one. Here is the same thing here. It's margin, winning margin, Zamalek by 1 goal. Why am I saying so? Because the difference here, 2-1, the difference is 1 goal. If you want to know the difference, if you're not sure, just say 2 minus 1. Then you will get your answer. And then here, Zamalek won this match by 2-0. What is the winning margin in this case? Then you should have chosen here, in this case, this one. Zamalek by 2 goals. Why am I saying 2 goals? If you check there, it's the difference between the scoreline of the losing team and the winning team is 2. How do you see it? You say Zamalek's scoreline, which is 2, and then minus Ishmael's scoreline, which is 0. Then you say 2 minus 0, you get 2. Then that's your answer. So you can see here, Zamalek, when they play this team, it's either they have a margin of 2 or 1, 2 or 1. So if you want to bet, I think you won't be wrong if you say Zamalek by 2 or 1. Okay, I think 2. Because Zamalek are so superior by the look of things. Playing few matches, but still they are leading. They are on top of that team. So this is what I think. I will only play these 2. And then I will combine these. There's my combined ticket. The odds are so good. You can see this is one good advantage about this winning margin. So Nkosinathi, I hope I explained this winning margin very good for you, and I hope you understand. And by the way, you've chosen a very good market. This is a good market, especially when you have analyzed teams like I did now, but even more. Just analyze teams properly and don't play too many teams. You can play 3 teams only, and then you put 100 bucks. You will make quick money with this market. This is a good market. That's my take on this. So I do have 100 bucks there, but I will put just 50 bucks. I'll just put 50 bucks. What? 50 rand. Nah, man. 50 rand. You can see there. With only 50 rand, I can make 1,000 bucks. If this thing happened like this, I'll just play. I'll just place it. Oh, what's happening now? Okay, the odds have changed. Okay, let me just put 50 again. The odds are going up and down. What's happening? Oh, leg 2. Okay, I must accept. Oh, the odds of Zamalek are increasing now. I wonder why. There we go. It's a success. My ticket is through. Hopefully this ticket will win. But that's the winning margin now. That's how you play winning margin, guys. I hope I did explain it nicely. For instance, here I'm expecting the scoreline now for Zamalek to be 2-0 or maybe 3-1 or maybe 4-2, something like that. And for Cleopatra, I'm expecting the scoreline to be 1-0, 2-1, 3-2. Difference of one goal there and a difference of two goals here. I hope I explained it properly. If I didn't, you can still leave a comment and I will keep on emphasizing more and more and more with more videos.